Hello, and welcome to the Magic Piano Advent Calendar. It is December 1st, 2021, and we are Sebastian Bausch and Manuel Bertsch, the creators of magic-piano.ch, a new website and online database about the piano role research at the University of the Arts in Bern, Switzerland. From today until Christmas Day, you will find a new video with a new and exciting piano role recording on this channel every day. These roles are part of our new digital role archive at magic-piano.ch, where you can find additional information on the recordings as well as the possibility to download the role scans as image files, MIDI files, and MP3 files.
The archive will grow steadily and we will add new roles every day till Christmas. At the heart of the archive is our goal to make available as many Veltemino recordings as possible of Beethoven's music. And that's why we will start today with some music by Beethoven.
And what could be more fitting for December 1st than to start with Beethoven's very first piano sonata, the sonata opus 2 number 1 in F minor.
Actually, it's not really the first piano sonata Beethoven ever wrote, but the first one he deemed worthy to receive an opus number.
And indeed, this sonata, and especially so its first movement, was considered to be paradigmatic for what is since called the classical sonata form. An analysis of how Beethoven develops motifs and form in this sonata can still be found in almost every textbook on musical form.
And since in the 19th century almost every discussion about musical performance centered around Beethoven's work, it's very interesting to observe how a pianist deeply rooted in the performance tradition of the 19th century approaches this work.
Herbert Freier recorded this sonata for Veltemignon on roll number 1582 on March 19th, 1909, while Velte made a visit to London with their recording equipment. He was a celebrated English pianist and professor in London.
At first glance, his interpretation might not appear as surprising and eccentric as those of pianists like Eugen d'Albert or Frédéric Lamont. But his very delicate performance is full of little details and subtleties, which create a lot of expression and demonstrate a deep personal involvement with the music.
You can observe that, especially in the way how he bends the rhythm or breaks the chords in response to expressive dissonances. We hope that you enjoy this performance as much as we do. And if you like to discover more of the treasures of the Veltemignon repertoire, then please subscribe to this channel and we'll be back with another role tomorrow. Thank you.